New figures just out show Sydney is once again leading the way as the property market heats up, despite high interest rates. But 10 News First can reveal tonight the suburbs across Sydney's southwest and inner west, where homeowners are being forced to sell at a loss after buying at the peak of the market during the pandemic.
Sitting pretty on a 552 square metre block, this two-storey, five-bed, four-bathroom home in Greenacre boasts an open-plan living with a fireplace and walls of glass. In July, it sold for $2.63 million. That figure, $63,000 less than when it sold in November 2022.
It's not just the sale price that they've lost. They're losing their stamp duty, their legal costs, the agent's fees. So it's actually a very expensive exercise.
Some homes that were purchased during the COVID boom and put back on the market are selling for a loss.
We've seen a tick up in properties that were bought, say, 2 or 3 years ago, being relisted for sale now.
Suburbs in Sydney's inner west and southwest have had the highest percentage of property sales that have made a loss over the past 18 months. Concord West and Bonnie Rig have the lion's share, followed by Fairfield West, Liverpool and Cabramatta West. Canley Vale rounds out the top 10.
We're seeing a lot of investors exit the market now as interest rates have increased very sharply.
It's devastating when you go in as an auctioneer and you can see that they haven't wanted to sell it, but they've had to sell it.
The trend is even more alarming when it comes to units. Suburbs in the Ryde and Parramatta councils have seen the largest shares of sales making a loss, with Epping leading the top 10.
I think it's starting to show that interest rates are really biting some households significantly.
But it's not all doom and gloom. Property prices in Sydney are still on the rise. The city continues to lead the market rebound after leading falls in 2022.
I think we should keep our eye out on the market for the next 3 months, where we see more listings come on September, October, November. That's going to give us a clearer picture.
Han Nguyen for 10 News First.